Here we are presenting the video of DSF76D soldering station integrated with solder feeder system sold by INDE Enterprises. So we will show you all its functions and working one by one. So let's start and switch it on. You will see the temperature is gradually rising and it's slowly attaining the set temperature. This station is very useful for spontaneous and uniform soldering, and it also avoids the wastage of solder wire. Two sockets are provided on the rear side of this unit to connect the solder wire and foot switch. We will show you how to increase and decrease the temperature by pressing push buttons provided on the front panel. Now let's move to the functions of solder feeding unit. We will start from the extreme right. Few micro switches are there to set the desired mode. If zero is selected as mode, the length of solder wire to be fed will depend how long we press the foot switch. The feeding of solder wire will immediately stop whenever we release the foot switch. Now, if one is selected as mode, set length of solder wire will be fed only once. And if the 2 to 9 mode is selected, then the set length of solder wire will be fed corresponding to the selected mode. For example, if mode 5 is selected, set length of solder wire will be fed. We have selected mode 5 and now this unit will solder 5 joints. We will show you. We will press the foot switch, first joint, second joint, third joint, fourth joint and fifth one. Now we have seen that the solder wire has fed 5 times, and with the combination of interval function we can keep delay of few microseconds between the each solder joint. Next we will move to speed. Speed push buttons are used to increase the speed of solder wire feeding. Return push buttons are used to activate the length of solder wire in backward direction. Push buttons provided on the length corner are used to set the desired length of solder wire to be fed. To next step, and we will show you how to calibrate this unit. First, we will measure the temperature of this soldering iron with the help of external calibrator, and we will show you the tip temperature. Tip temperature is around 390 on the calibrator, whereas on the display of soldering unit it's 400 degrees. So it's a difference of around 10 degree. First we will press star, then we will simultaneously press up and down button and the cursor will start blinking. Now we will use star to move the cursor next, and we will feed the value which we have observed on the calibrator. Then we will again press star button, and we will see when the display is stable, then we will verify the temperature once again. Now we will see the temperature on soldering unit is almost same, and which is also displayed on the calibrator. See, in this way this unit is calibrated. Thanks for watching this video. Have a nice day.